Metacognition. In this session, we'll be learning about introduction to metacognition, John Flavel's contribution on metacognition, cognitive versus metacognitive strategies, metacognitive strategies. At the end of this module, you'll be able to define metacognition, discuss John Flavel's contribution on metacognition, compare cognitive and metacognitive strategies, explain metacognitive strategies. Let's see what is metacognition. Look at this picture, Surin. How many times you have asked this question to yourself about your planning, maybe when you are stuck with some idea, maybe after doing an activity? Does this question come to your mind? Do you actually think about it? So this is nothing but metacognition. Metacognition is one of the latest buzzwords in educational psychology. There are different complicated, complex definitions of metacognition. But if we try to put it in a simpler words, according to John H. Flavel in 1979, he simply said, metacognition is nothing but thinking about your own thinking. According to Flavel, metacognition consists of both metacognitive knowledge and metacognitive experiences or regulation. So according to John Flavel, 1979, metacognition includes two parts. First is knowing about your thinking. That is nothing but your metacognitive knowledge. And second is controlling your thinking. That is metacognitive control. So metacognitive knowledge includes knowledge of person variables, knowledge of task variables, knowledge of strategy variables. Now, what does metacognitive control? Metacognitive control. It is ability to do something or to take action to control cognitive activity. Metacognitive knowledge. So, under metacognitive knowledge, first we'll talk about knowledge of person variable. Knowledge of person variable refers to the general knowledge about how human beings learn and process information, as well as individual knowledge of one's own learning processes. Look at this picture. Here there is one girl who's saying that I can learn better by reading books. So she is aware that her learning can be better by reading books, whereas the other girl feels that if she is going to make use of concept map, then she is going to learn better. Similarly, you also must have experienced that some of you can learn better if they read or study in the library, or some of you might have experienced that they can study better at their own home. So the second part under metacognition knowledge is knowledge of task variables. Knowledge of task variable is nothing but when you are aware about the variables of the task and the processing time, means how much difficult is the task and how much time you will require to complete the task. You might have experienced that when you are referring some book or when you are working on some project, you might have experienced there are some chunks which you can solve it or comprehend it easily, whereas there are some part of the lesson which you take more time to comprehend or to by heart. So this is nothing but the knowledge of task variable. Look at this picture. Here the child is saying that I can comprehend a story faster than a science theory. So he has comprehended the task, that is story learning is easier as compared to learning a science theory. So finally, we have knowledge about strategy variables, which include knowledge about both cognitive and metacognitive strategies, as well as our conditional knowledge about when and where it is appropriate to use such strategies. So what are the strategies which you are going to make use of? Look at this picture. Here there is a boy who is thinking, is this the right way to fix this car? So he is thinking whether this strategy will work to repair his car. Similarly, when you do some educational exercise and when you are working on some assignment, you many a time you think about it, whether this mnemonic will work for my presentation or by hearting or retention of certain concept or diagrammatic representation will work. So these are nothing but knowledge of strategy variables. So far we talked about metacognitive knowledge. So the second part is metacognitive control or regulation. So the second aspect of metacognition is metacognitive control or regulation. What does it mean? It means controlling your thinking. This is a stage where your cognition as well as metacognition both are working. So at the same time, you are paying attention to your strategies also, and you are rechecking about the content also. Look at this picture. Here the girl is saying, I don't understand what is e-commerce. Perhaps I should reread this section. So here she is focusing on the content also of e-commerce that she is not able to understand. At the same time, she is trying to regulate it by thinking of rereading of the section. So let's talk about some strategies. Before we talk about metacognitive strategies, it is very essential to understand the difference between cognitive strategies and metacognitive strategies. Though many a time it may happen that cognitive strategies and metacognitive strategies may overlap, but still there is a difference between cognitive strategy and metacognitive strategy. That I'll help you to understand by taking an example of reading comprehension. When you are reading a comprehension, that time you are using your cognitive strategy. Here the objective is to understand the content. For example, if I'm reading, a paragraph is given to me and there are questions given below that, and I look for the meaning of that. So there I am using my cognitive strategy, but later on I evaluate my understanding of the text, how far I was able to answer question out of 5, say maybe 4 or 3. So that becomes my metacognitive strategy, because here I am ensuring about my goal, that how far I have understood the concept. So I may be again going back and rereading it, re-revising it. So that is nothing but my metacognitive strategy. As a teacher, we need to enhance metacognition among our students, and for that we need to plan out some strategies to develop metacognition among our students. So for that, peer learning is an effective strategy by which we can develop metacognition among our students. We can ask students to collaborate and learn from each other, where a material can be given to them and they can be posing question and they can be answering in pair or in group. That can even lead to a dialogic learning, where questioning, finding out answer, revisiting the content, reviewing the content can happen, and lot of peer learning can take place. There are lot of research which are done to find out the study strategies which are metacognitive in nature. For example, SQ3R, that can be used, where some material can be given to the student and following steps can be followed, like survey, where they will be reading chapter outlines, chapter headings, recaps and objective. Questioning, where they will be formulating questions that they believe will be addressed in their reading. Then they can be reading material quickly, carefully, as well as actively, and try to answer their previously formulated questions. And they can be reciting it, that means that they can be saying those answers loudly, and they can again go back over whatever they have learned and use study guide, reread it, recap it, review it, or summarize it. Similarly, we have SQ4R, where there is one more section added, which is relate, where they can relate it to their previous knowledge as well as to their current knowledge. Making prediction, hypothesis. Hypothesis is an intelligent guess. So we need to make our student make predictions about certain thing. Before we actually start with an experiment, we can ask student to make the tentative guess, like what will happen if I add A to B? So what will be the product C? Similarly, in languages, looking at the headings of the newspaper, what predictions you can make out that what this article may be. So all these exercises will help to enhance their metacognition. Relate ideas. Students are full of ideas. They may come up with many ideas. So it is very essential to give direction to their ideas, to work upon their ideas, and to relate their ideas to some sound principles and theories, and then again making them incubate that, verify that, and again come with a new product. So that is very helpful in terms of metacognitive strategy. Develop questions. Now when we talk about questions, we are always listen to the questions given by teachers, but have you ever thought that even students can be creating questions and they can be finding answers of that? When we were talking about SQ3R or SQ4R, so there again we talked about questions. So anything, whatever topic they are going to learn about, we can make them think about intelligent questions, ask intelligent questions. So develop that habit of questioning, because when you question, then that leads to curiosity, that leads to imagination, research, searching for the information, even to reflect about their thinking and then to come up with the idea. So that is also one of the effective metacognitive strategy. Summary. So we have seen what is metacognition, the difference between metacognition and cognition, even the Flavel's model of metacognition, where he talked about metacognition knowledge and metacognitive control. Under metacognitive knowledge, we learnt about person variable, task variable, even strategy variable. We talked about some of the strategies which can be implemented to enhance metacognition among students. So though there is a lot of research which has been done about the concept of metacognition, but there is a need to implement metacognitive strategies at school level, at classroom level, where students can be actively engaged using effective metacognitive strategies. Thank you.